As the developer tools team of Microsoft Edge, we get a lot of questions about customization. So here are some of the things you can do to make developer tools your own that you may not know about. First of all, you can undock the developer tools into an own window, or you can dock them to the bottom right or left of the browser by clicking the three-dot overflow menu and selecting the different icons. Some tools use up the whole space, and others have a top and bottom drawer showing contextual tools. If you dock developer tools to the left, these will display as rows if there isn't a lot of space, and as columns if there is enough. If you hit the Escape key, you can also open a bottom drawer to show even more tools. By default, this will be the console tool. You can add tools by hitting the plus button, and you can open the context menu to move tools to the lower panel or back up. This allows you to fully customize the layout to your needs. If you open a tool by accident, you can remove it by clicking the X next to it. Notice that the Elements, Console and Sources tool don't have that X, as they are considered essential. If you need to change the font and overall size of the developer tools, you can press Ctrl and plus to make them larger, and Ctrl and minus to make them smaller. Pressing Ctrl and 0 will reset the size. You can change a lot more in the settings by activating the cog icon or pressing F1. You can show the tools in different languages, or you can choose different themes, for example. If you want full control, you can also open the command palette by pressing Ctrl, Shift and P. This allows you to do all the actions we've shown by typing commands and selecting from a list rather than using a mouse. You can switch themes, show different tools, and you can access functionality of the tools without opening them. For example, you can see the current website in forced colors mode, which is a feature of the rendering tool.